Hydrodynamic of the weathering mantle. The hydrodynamics of the alteration mantle in the tropical zones present, globally, two hydrogeological levels illustrated in. These distinctions are based on the hydraulic characteristics of confining layers. The iron crust has alveolar permeability due to its structure and fracture permeability due to its dismantling. It promotes rapid infiltration into areas where it is preserved from subsequent erosion. The voids present below the indurated level can create a strong permeability contrast with the altered level, a laterite, giving rise to a locally perched aquifer with a few sources that exhibit an epikarst-type function. In the case of heavy precipitation, the temporary water table in this aquifer can be loaded under the iron crust and give rise locally to artesian sources. Its hydrodynamic properties, high porosity and low permeability, give it the capacitive function of the aquifer system. Seepage areas may be locally observed on outcrops of laterites during high water events. Its lower part, coarse saprolite, composed of very weathered rock and relatively healthy blocks, facilitates the circulation of water. This gives it a transmissive function, thus feeding the main resurgences of the slopes and the stream's base flow. The rates obtained in the aquifer of alterites are of the order of 1 cubic meter height. The distinction between different types of aquifers is often difficult. It is necessary to have data about subsurface lithology, water levels, and hydraulic parameters of aquifer and confining layers for identifying a particular type of aquifer. The common groundwater structures used to study the hydrodynamic operation of aquifers are wells, springs, and boreholes. Wells are generally dug to the base of loose alterite as the springs emerge either between the alaterite and the overlying horizon or between the isalterite, coarse saprolite, and the upper fissured horizon, saprock. Boreholes most often pick up the basement or basement alterite system whose behavior is sometimes comparable to that of a shallow unconfined aquifer. The data presented in this work relate only to springs and wells. The discharges of springs vary between 0.04 and 6.2 cubic meters/h against 0.06 and half a cubic meter/h in the wells. The recession coefficients of springs vary between 0.001 and 0.016/d against 0.06 and 0.39 meters/month at wells. Springs emerging on the coarse saprolite-saprock continuum generally have the highest flow rates. This observation is consistent with that of the other authors, which indicates that it is at fissured horizon that the hard rock aquifers owe their productivity. At the lithological scale, the order of magnitude of productivity of the springs is between 0.03 and 3.2 cubic meters/h and between 0.03 and 6.2 cubic meters/h, respectively, in metapludinites and metasediments. This difference of a factor of 2 is not significant with the depths of groundwater, which vary between 0.0 and 17.7 meters, with an average of 5.7 plus or minus 6.2 meters in the whole of the area. In the Mafundi watershed, these depths differ by about 4 meters between the two banks, either between 0.0 and 13.5 meters on the right bank or 0.1 and 17.7 meters on the left bank. Its hydrodynamic characteristics indicate that the aquifer has, in places, highly heterogeneous areas. The ancient tectonic structuring EW at NWSC, 592 Ma at 658 Ma, controls the orientation of the hydrographic network. Thus, the landscape form, which is shaped by the hydrographic network, is at the origin of the upstream-downstream underground flows conforming to the outline of the topography, namely, NNE, NS, EU, and SA to SE. The average piezometric amplitudes corresponding to this altitudinal distribution range between 1.3 and 3.1 meters in the summit zones, between 0.7 and 1.1 meters in the mid-slope zones, and between 0.3 and 0.6 meters in the valleys where the watercourse is generally the imposed potential. The seasonal dynamics of the Yaounde shallow unconfined aquifer, alterite, are, in general, similar to those observed in the basement zone, in humid tropical climates. The piezometric increases are observed during the great rainy season and vice versa during the dry season. The discharge of the aquifer evolves according to an exponential law characteristic of environments with high inertia. This inertia and/or the continuous/discontinuous nature of the aquifer reservoir may be at the origin of piezometric anomalies, characterized by a piezometric increase in the dry season and a decrease in the rainy season. According to These piezometric anomalies indicate areas of high transmissivity. The relationship between well and spring's behavior and rainfall has a lag of about 1 month, figures 5 and 6, that can be attributed to morphopedological processes. Some authors attribute this lagging to delayed drainage between recharge and drainage areas and the evapotranspiration of one part of the rain, so the degree of soil moisture during the periods preceding rainy phases. Some wells have a rapid response to precipitation. This rapid response of the water table to rainfall depends on the geological units or the water level position. This position classifies the water table at local, regional, and continental scales. Indeed, the character of the water table is fundamental to conceptualize the groundwater flow systems and to examine the connections between groundwater, surface water, and climate. Unfortunately, studies on the classification of groundwater at various scales are limited throughout the Mufindi Basin and surrounding areas. Graphic illustrating the evolution of the average values of the flow of the sources and the fluctuations of the piezometric levels in the Olizoa watershed, 2010 to 2011. P equals effective precipitation, RFU equals available water content of the soil. Graphic illustrating the evolution of the groundwater depths of some dug wells showing the piezometric anomaly in the Olizoa watershed, 2010 to 2011. However, ongoing work in the Olizoa watershed has identified two topographic scales highlighting the concept of hierarchical groundwater flow systems. Beyond this hierarchy, the two scales nevertheless suggest that the piezometric surface is much more controlled by the topography than by the recharge. In the first case, water table generally coincides with the topographic surface, and the depths of water table are small. In the second case, the depths are high, and the water table is totally disconnected from the topography. In the humid tropical zones, the fluctuation of groundwater levels in weathered layer, alterites, is controlled to varying degrees by effective rainfall, the streams, topography, the thickness of the saturated portion of the saprolite, and pumping extracting. Fluctuations in groundwater levels are dynamic responses of the system to recharge, input water, and discharge, lose water. The evolution of the discharge according to an exponential law, figures 5 and 6, is characteristic of a water table fed mainly by vertical contributions. Several approaches are used to evaluate these input water, recharge/infiltration, including empirical methods, base flow measurement methods, water table fluctuation, WTF, method, chloride balance method, soil moisture method, isotope method, or mathematical methods. The application of some of these methods in the Yaounde area indicates that the recharge of shallow aquifer of Yaounde migmatitic basement is recent and is done directly by infiltration of precipitation without any notable change due to evaporation. The average isotope contents of 18O of rain and shallow groundwater are, respectively, -2.47 and -2.57 versus SMO with annual and monthly isotope signature differences in precipitation values. Groundwater recharge appears to occur in May, October, and November, figures 5 and 6, and increase from 30 mm/year in the lowland to 40 mm/year in the highland. The infiltration coefficient varies between 5.7 and 7.5% according to the chlorine balance method, 6% with a WTF, and between 5 and 23% according to the Thornthwaite method with an available water content of the soil, RFU max, of 100 mm.